crowd of better than 15,000 here in Sacramento. It is the biggest fight to take place in the state of California in terms of gate receipts, passing by the previous high, Muhammad Ali, Ken Norton at the LA Forum in September of 73. We're set for the introductions. Let's go to the ring. Here's Jim Hall.
For the IBF Junior Lightweight Championship of the World, our referee for this contest is Robert Byrd. Introducing first the challenger in the red corner. This young man is wearing the white trunks with the red and green trim. He weighs 130 pounds. He's from Mexicali, Mexico, with a record of 35 wins, 2 losses, 3 draws, with 25 wins by knockout. He is the IBF Featherweight Champion of the World. Here's Jorge Maromero Paez. Fighting out of the blue corner, this young man is wearing the tiger trunks. He weighs 129 3/4 pounds. He's from Sacramento, California, with a record of 35 wins, 2 losses, with 24 wins by knockout. Here's the IBF Junior Lightweight Champion of the World, Tony the Tiger Lopez.
Referee Robert Byrd out of Los Angeles. Robert Byrd has handled 5 world title fights, including the second meeting between Lopez and Rocky Lockridge. It should also be pointed out that he is a commander with the California State Police. The judges, Larry Lozadilla of Los Angeles, Dave Nelson Jr. out of San Jose, California, and Rudy Ortega from San Francisco. It is scheduled for 12. And we are underway. Both Lopez and Paez in the past have been slow starters. Both have had weight problems in the past.
Now, Lopez was telling me yesterday, why give away this first round? I'm going to come out and take this first round, but it doesn't look like Paez is going to sleep either. He's staying in the middle of the ring, as he should, exerting his superior boxing skill. Right now, Tony on the attack, as you can expect him to be all afternoon long. Paez doing half of Tyson's. He only got one sock on. You know, on the other leg, he has nothing.
Jorge Paez won the IBF featherweight crown back in March of 1989 by taking a majority decision over Calvin Grove. Came from behind to do it. He put Grove down 3 times and then closed with a huge 15th round. Prior to that dramatic win, Paez noted only for his connections with his family's circus and for the tradition of breakdancing and moonwalking before and after fights.
Well, he has a strange feature. He fights as good as his opposition. When he's really facing someone good like Tony Lopez, you can expect the best out of Paez. For Lopez to commit and then counterpunching. Nice hook by Paez.
Lopez is the stronger puncher. He is a pressure fighter, likes to have his opponent right in front of him. Paez usually that kind of opponent.
Yeah, he has no problem now. He's not going to the body as he said he would. Lopez said, I'm going straight to the body. I can't hit his head. He moves it around. He goes right to the head now and is neglecting the body. His game plan was to pull him into the ropes, pull Paez in, beat his body and wear him out, but he has not done either one of those two things up to now.
Half minute remaining in this opening round.
Paez very sharp in counterpunching, very sharp.
And both Lopez and Paez off to quicker starts than usual. Yeah. first round from Sacramento, California, as Lopez is able to land. Has ruled a slip.
It's a miracle he didn't do a spring after that. Tony Lopez was so aware of getting hit after the bell, he said, I am not going to take that. I'm going to hit him back no matter what.
And Paez now going to the counter.
I am amazed that he has eschewed the body. He has not gone to the body as Tony Lopez, and therefore he hasn't hit anything. He's throwing to the head and he's missing. Getting nailed in counterpunch by Paez, who's razor sharp this morning, this afternoon.
Or this evening.
Or sometime today.
Depending where you are. And it gone by, second round, it is scheduled for 12. At stake is the IBF Junior Lightweight crown of Tony Lopez, going against the IBF Featherweight Champion, Jorge Paez.
Turning his head when a big punch comes makes it look like he got hit by the punch, but Tony Lopez missed it by a good 3 or 4 inches. Count the many times that Lopez throws for the head and misses and gets hit in counterpunch. Exactly the opposite of what he said he was going to do.
Paez off balance. You can see the legs wobble momentarily.
This guy's such an acrobat that I don't think there is such a thing as off balance for him. Just when it looks like anybody else would fall down, he recovers.
Strong left hand delivered by Paez. A bit much of a spin move, according to the referee, Robert Byrd. And he settles that in a hurry.
He doesn't want any wrestling around like that on the ring. What Lopez is trying to do is make him get tired. He's much stronger than Paez, so he wants to throw him around. Referee says, uh-uh, not my ring.
Coming up on 10 seconds left in the second. Sacramento, California, with the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco. I'm Marv Albert. It is round three of a scheduled 12-rounder. Tony Lopez going against Jorge Paez. Paez, incidentally, wearing white, green, and red, the colors of Mexico. And Lopez in his usual tiger stripe trunks.
That's a great body shot by Tony Lopez, who has been neglecting his body attack. So far, it's been exactly the opposite from what was predicted. Look, Paez has started out fast. He didn't blow those first two rounds. Lopez has not gone to the body, just gone kind of head hunting, and I think they've settled him down in the corner. They've said, hey, let's get back to business. Let's go to the body and do our work. Also, Paez is in the middle of the ring, right where he wants to be. He is not up against the ropes where Lopez wanted him to be. It has been completely the opposite of what everybody thought was going to happen.
Chant of Tony from this crowd. Interesting pre-fight ritual Oh, good right hand by Lopez. And Paez gives the indication that he was not hurt by that at all. Tony Lopez's mom, Rachel, goes through a pre-fight ritual. She pinches the cheeks of Tony Lopez and will tell him before the fight, now don't get hit in the face.
Mom, body shots hurt.
Yes.
I'd rather them hit me in the face. Lopez having his best round so far. He is having his way this round. And that's a strong suit of Tony Lopez. He may blow two rounds, but don't count him out because he just keeps coming every round. And he's having a good one this time.
How did you score the first two?
I scored them both for Paez by a very squeaky narrow margin, but it's 20-18 on my scorecard over the first two rounds.
Scoring on the 10-point must system handled by three judges all from California. Good combination landed by Lopez. No standing eight count in effect. No three knockdown rule. The ball does not save the fighter in any round, including the final round.
Paez is cut over his right at the connection of the nose and the eyebrow of the right eye. Not big, but he is cut. Again, completely contrary to what was expected. Right, he's expecting Tony to cut up, and Tony's face looks very well right now, whereas Paez has a small nick.
Yes, Lopez has had problems in the past with cuts, which have slowed him down at times. We'll be right back.
He's right back to what won him that last one, digging into the body of the smaller, but standing right in front of you, Paez. There's no motion here, folks. This is all punching.
And the referee, Robert Byrd, talking to both Lopez and Paez about the headbutts. With a record of 35-2, 25 by knockout. He's also been involved in three draws. The two defeats took place early in his career, both by decision in six-round bouts. And Lopez at 35-2. Lopez recapturing the IBF Junior Lightweight title by taking a 12-round decision over John Molina, avenging that TKO loss to Molina here in Sacramento last October. Molina taking the title away, and the fans here at Arco Arena not pleased about the stoppage. Let their feelings be known by showering debris, creating that ugly scene that you saw a glimpse of earlier.
You can see the tide turn slightly now as Lopez is pursuing. Not much, but he's backing up Paez, and Paez is getting dangerously close to these ropes. Once his back touches those ropes and he lets Tony wail away at the body, then it is Lopez's fight, and Lopez is getting there.
For Tony Lopez. This is round five. Tony Lopez defending his IBF junior lightweight title against the IBF featherweight champion, Jorge Paez. The feeling is, should Paez win, he would then go up against the undisputed lightweight champion, Pernell Whitaker, within 6 months. Lopez, with no desire to fight Whitaker, we're told.
Again, the body attack driving Paez back to the ropes. Now his back is to the ropes, and that's exactly what Lopez wants. Paez has sort of taken the last two rounds off. He doesn't have the same excitement. He doesn't have the same counter-punching ability. Something's gone out of him, and it could be those hard body shots by Lopez. I have it dead even on my card right now, 38-38 with Lopez coming on.
Three judges are from the state of California. Larry Rosadita. In fact, he's the only judge that had Buster Douglas ahead of Mike Tyson in their world title fight back in February. Dave Nelson Jr. from San Jose. Rudy Ortega out of San Francisco, the other judge. Actually, a compromise decision after both camps objected to Terry Smith, who happens to hail from Sacramento.
Well, I think that it's regrettable. This fight is so good that you don't need the suggestion of impropriety. Everybody here is from California, and here is Paez from Mexico. I think they should have at least had a Mexican. And even if it gets to be a close decision, everybody will say, well, you had California. It wasn't necessary. Too great a fight.
You're saying the perception is wrong of three California judges.
Absolutely, and it might change the fight. Back to the fight. Is waking up now. He's chasing Lopez. Well, he's taking a nice break. You better get back to work.
And now Tony Lopez, who at times has shown a cocky personality, puts the hands down. Very adventurous and dangerous. Well, that's a cue for Paez.
That's his ball game.
Said, don't clown with it. Every time you clown, it's his ball game. He punches when he clowns.
It is on to round six, scheduled for 12.
Great little exchange there. Lopez to the body and Paez to the head. Boy, that's what you call an even exchange. Neither fighter showing any respect for the other, and they're certainly willing to stand in each other's face and throw. And what a wonderful inside uppercut Paez just threw.
Tony Lopez in the tiger stripe trunks, consisting of, although he may dispute this, imitation tiger skin, in keeping with his nickname. And Jorge Paez wearing the white, green, and red, the colors of Mexico.
Paez doing the leading now, and Tony trying to counterpunch. Tony's much better when he leads.
once again, the crowd chanting for Tony Lopez, who landed the left hook. And solid right hands delivered by Paez.
Paez is raining punches from all angles. They're coming out uppercuts, looping hooks, hooks to the body. Again, Lopez starting to clown. That's like, I need a little break here. Stop, let me clown a little bit. Almost an admission that he's taking too much here.
Come to the end of round six. Welcome back to the Arco Arena, Sacramento, California. The home of the Sacramento Kings of the NBA. And it's an arena that Tony Lopez calls home as he defends his IBF Junior lightweight title. This is round seven. Marv Albert with the fight doctor, Freddie Pacheco, Jorge Paez, the IBF featherweight champion, one of the more unorthodox fighters of the world, throwing punches from all angles, exceptional balance. That's where that circus activity background has helped.
But right now, it's a hard fight to judge, and that's going to make this final, if it goes to decision, the final decision, either hoots and howls or roars, because we've got a very close, each one has been close, depending on who is leading in the action. The last two Paez has led in the action. Who punches the hardest? The last two Paez has punched the hardest. And it's going back and forth between these two.
Freddie, should it go to decision, and should that decision go against Lopez, we certainly hope it is only hoots and howls.
Well, if you're in Paez's corner and you got three judges from California, what would you be telling your fighter? And you would be saying you need a knockout or else.
I don't know how they could accept that.
I don't either.
I don't understand how they could be talked into that type of situation.
The suggestion of impropriety is what's wrong. I mean, even if the judges are as good as you can get them, they're still under a heck of a ball onus.
Most interesting sledgehammer-like shot thrown by Paez.
It was almost a chop one. Well, none of the judges seems to bother Jorge Paez. He is just one of those guys that's got his mind on the guy in front of him, and he doesn't worry about anything else. I don't even think he listens to his corner very much. According to his corner, they can't get him to do anything they want.
Approaching a half minute to go in the seventh round. It is scheduled for 12. They got off to a furious start. It has slowed down the last couple of rounds.
But they're inside and they're hammering each other. It doesn't look like much, but they're doing a lot of damage inside. Again, the judges, who's driving who back? Who is hammering the other hardest? Who's missing the most? Very close fight to score.
On to round eight. And Freddie, we have our Paez sledgehammer cam at work here.
Yeah, he throws punches from all angles, and he doesn't care what he throws, chopping blows or what he does. I tell you, It is a close fight. I have it 66 to 67, and I can see how it could be either way the way these guys are going. Evander Holyfield got the biggest hand I've heard in this place outside of Lopez. He is a big popular favorite here.
Evander sitting with Vinny Pazienza, who will be going up against Loretto Garza for the WBA Junior Welterweight Crown. That'll be here in Sacramento in December.
Oh, look at that body attack of Lopez. Lopez getting right on track. Look at that. That's where the points are built up, right there in the body. Paez gives you his flanks. You can punch to the side all you want.
And that is Rachel Lopez in the glasses, Tony's mom.
Good, solid, connecting shots by Lopez, who goes right back down to where it pays off, the body. Now, this is the best round he's connected to the head as Tony Lopez, because he's been missing that head, but hitting the body. Now he's working it down and over.
And Lopez is the harder puncher. Paez does have power, but he's not a one-punch knockout artist, does it with combinations.
And right now he's throwing powder puff punches. Nothing on his punches. Low blows, very low blows by Lopez, and not a word from the referee, who's on the wrong side of it. Doesn't see it.
Good counter by both. Lopez with the strong right hand, and here's Paez back.
Connecting, no end of heart on both, on the part of both fighters.
Just under 1 minute remaining in the eighth round. Again, Paez with the unorthodox punch.
Nice countering shot by Lopez.
Excellent action round.
Lopez zeroing in on a perfect punch. Watch this. Whang! Back goes the head of Paez, and Paez, not stopped, comes right back fighting. That was an action-packed round. Very good for Tony Lopez, who seems to be getting stronger as this fight goes on, and Paez getting weaker.
So we have come eight complete. What does the fight doctor scorecard show?
I have it dead even, and 76-76. Although when you're in Sacramento, I can certainly understand it. If Lopez is ahead here, the crowd is screaming.
Uppercuts by Paez getting in. Lopez right back.
Lopez getting much stronger and much more sure of his punches than he was through those first four or five rounds, when he was very tentative, trying to hit a head that just won't stand still. Right now, Paez's head is a target. He is not moving it.
Most of this bout has taken place at the center of the ring. We are so accustomed to see Paez along the ropes.
Paez, I would not be surprised to go to the ropes in the next two or three rounds, because he looks very tired now. His punches have nothing in them, and that's the kind of dogged performance that gets him into the corner.
And Paez doing a lot of covering up and saying, come on, and that's exactly what Lopez is doing. Lopez hearing it from the crowd with a minute and 20 remaining in the ninth round.
Excellent combinations for Tony Lopez, who's beginning to do what he planned to do, drive him to the ropes, drive Paez and belabor his body. Paez no longer that target, that elusive target, now standing straight and not punching with great authority. Those were the first hard punches he threw just a second ago.
And there is obvious mutual respect between the two. You get the idea they're actually enjoying each other out there.
Well, both of them were just like young kids going to a dance yesterday. They couldn't wait to get it on, so I think they're having fun.
Some kind of fun banging each other around.
That's their profession.
Better than 15,000 on hand here at Arco Arena. It is a record crowd for the state of California in terms of gate receipts. It has been the toughest ticket in this area for many weeks.
Tony looking very sharp.
They're counting down the final seconds of round 9. Tony Lopez out of Sacramento, California, comes in at 35-2, 24 by knockout. He is defending his IBF junior lightweight title against the 24-year-old from Mexicali, Mexico, Jorge Paez, a one-time circus acrobat and clown, boxing's clown prince. And Paez, the IBF featherweight champ, but at stake is the title of Lopez. And this is round 10. It is scheduled for 12.
The little nick on the eye of Paez has not caused him any trouble, and there has not been even a suggestion of a cut on Tony Lopez, a surprise in both instances. Found the formula. He's punching harder with much more effect, that and connecting more to the head of Paez. That because Paez is not moving his head as he did in the first 5 rounds, but standing straight in front of him and standing up.
Crowd reacting against the slapping attempts of Jorge Paez. This will be, if it does go the distance, a very difficult fight to score. Would you explain those punches thrown by Paez?
They're south of the border punches. They don't need explanation. Paez has got to get on track here. He's blowing round after round, and that's going to be very difficult here in Sacramento. All California judges in a huge crowd roaring with everything that Lopez does.
What do you have on the scorecard?
I have Lopez ahead, 86-85, as he has taken these last 3 rounds, just marching in straight order.
Good counter by Lopez. Doubling and tripling up with the left hand, but Lopez came right back. That will do it for round 10. Paez in the white, green, and red against Tony the Tiger Lopez, appropriately enough, in the Tiger Stripe trunks. And last round heroics have won several fights for Paez, it should be pointed out, a meeting against Calvin Grove, the first bout against Troy Dorsey, the second fight against Louis Espinosa. In fact, Paez has said that he prefers a 15-round title at distance. Takes him a while to get going, although he did start quicker than usual here today.
Well, he started very well, but he's faded under the body attack of Tony Lopez, and Tony has just gotten harder and harder as these rounds go by, and he doesn't need a big last round. He needs a big last two rounds. He needs round 11 and round 12 back. Tony is fighting under controlled violence.
But not much effect, although the crowd reacts.
Big points when you go to the body with four or five unanswered shots.
Now you have Lopez up now by 2 points.
Yeah, I think he's ahead by two, and if some of those close rounds go the other way, which I'm sure they will in Sacramento, he's got a big lead here. Seem to have the energy, the gas, the strength to put on a very big finish against a guy that's not giving him an inch. Tony Lopez is not conceding anything. He's just there to win every round.
And much of this crowd chanting for the hometown boxer, Tony Lopez, just under 1 minute to go in the 11th round. As we head to the possibility of this bout going the distance, and for those of you familiar as to what took place back last October when a decision in the fight against John Molina went against Tony Lopez, I'm told they cut off beer sales at the start of the fight here at Arco Arena to help prevent a repetition of the mini riot that occurred.
Well, I am thankful for that, but how about the people who brought six packs?
No good.
Seconds of the 11th. So this one is headed for a 12th and final round, and we'll stay right here.
Okay, give me three dead back out of my real floor. I don't want either.
In the corner of Tony Lopez, trainer Will Edgington, his dad Sal, cut man Norm Lockwood.
Okay, Tony, this is the final round of the fight. Okay? If he lands two, you land three. If he lands three, you get in four.
Right.
But keep them hands up.
Last round. Last round.
Don't get careless, Tony. You're ahead. You don't get careless if you hit one.
Tony Lopez defending his IBF Junior Lightweight Championship.
Respect in yours, too. So, and don't give him any chance.
I guess I'm told about
and you. Jorge Paez with Nacho Weezar, his manager and babysitter, as he likes to be referred to, and 74-year-old cutman Chuck Bodak. 12th and final round. As I mentioned earlier, Paez was trailing on points, but knocked down Calvin Grove three times in the 15th round to win his title. That was back in August of 88. And you get the feeling he needs a fast finish right here.
Well, he'll certainly need that miracle because he's behind, and that's about the only way he can pull it out. Paez, on the other hand, not fighting like a man desperate. He's not fighting possessed. He doesn't look like he's going after that knockout.
The only two losses over the course of the career, Jorge Paez, took place early in his career, both by decision in six-round bouts. 1 minute in, final round.
This round, not much different from the others.
referee Robert Byrd getting between the fighters.
Tony Lopez has done a very good job at sticking to his game plan. He's ahead and he just wants to weather this round out.
Checking with his corner as we approach 1 minute to go in the bout. Otto Arena is walking. To 30 seconds remaining in the fight.
And that was the charge of the Light Brigade for Paez, who's desperate now. Good hard shot by Paez.
Final seconds off the bell. Tony Lopez and Jorge Paez go the distance. Champion, hoping to successfully defend against the IBF featherweight champ Jorge Paez. So it will go to the scorecards. All three judges from the state of California. Set for the decision, here's Jim Hall.
Dave Nelson, Larry Rosadilla, Judge Rudy Ortega, all three judges scoring at 117-111, winner by unanimous decision.
Successfully defending his IBF junior lightweight crown by decision against Jorge Paez. Let's go to the fight doctor.
That body attack was absent in those first rounds, but then you went to it. Do you think that turned the tide?
Well, I think sometimes I slowed him down, and I forgot what round it was, but I was talking to Will, and I told him he stopped punching. He punched pretty hard. Punched pretty good for a featherweight coming up to a junior lightweight. I just wanted to take my time, and if I couldn't take him out, just outpoint him. So.
Do you think you got him out of his clowning?
A little bit, you know, did a little bit myself, you know, just pony do it when he wasn't hitting so hard anymore. So.
You look like you were having a good time, though.
Oh, I was. I had a good time this fight. Just everything that Will told me to do, and I did it.
Where do you go from here? Do you think Pernell Whitaker's in your future?
It's up to Will. Whatever Will says, I go.
All right. Back to Marv Albert at ringside.
All right, Ferdy, Tony Lopez. Now, considering what is next, we were told before the fight that if Paez was able to defeat Lopez, he would go against the undisputed lightweight champion, Pernell Sweet Pea Whitaker. But the feeling is that Lopez was looking in other directions. But as he said, it's up to his trainer, Will Edgington. A terrific fight between Jorge Paez and Tony Lopez, an anticipated matchup for many months.